Welcome parents to the 8th grade graduation. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Salute.
The United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for the national anthem.
Pastor Garrett Andrew, who will do the invocation for our ceremony.
Afternoon, and welcome to St. Andrew Presbyterian Church. I'm glad you're here. I'm more glad y'all are here. How you guys doing? Let's pray. Eternal friend, I am incredibly glad that we have here gathered graduates from the 8th grade moving on to high school. We have parents who are proud. We have teachers who are excited to see those they've been teaching move on. And so God, I ask that you remind us today is a regular day for a whole lot of the world. But for those who are sitting behind me, for those who are sitting in front of me, today is a remarkable day. God, I ask that you plant within each person a seed of hope, that this day might not just be a memory, but something that becomes so much more. As these young people, God, move into the future, grant them strength and courage to continue their education in such a way that every teacher, every parent, every administrator, they themselves might be so proud of who they are in this moment and of who they're about to become, that this world never be the same. Lord, grant them love for all that they've done and all that they will do. We pray this in your strong name. Amen.
Good evening and welcome, students, trustees, distinguished guests, parents, staff, families, and friends. Of all the rituals and observances in American culture, academic promotion is perhaps one of the most celebrated in modern times. The step from middle school to high school is a very big one. It's the beginning of your transition from child to adult. High school students have a much greater responsibility at YCCS than most public schools. You will become leaders. You establish the tone and the attitude of the school. You are the example for the younger children. Your responsibility is to be good role models for all of the students following you, to demonstrate academic excellence and achievement, to uphold the highest example of behavior, tolerance, and cooperation. Growing up is not easy, but that is exactly what you are doing tonight. High school is a right and a privilege, but it is also an important responsibility that you have to your family, your school, your peers, most of all to yourself. Congratulations on accomplishing this first and most important step toward becoming an adult. We see potential in your future. We're proud of you. From this moment forward, you are high school students with all the responsibilities and opportunities that go with it. Make these next 4 years count. They will pass more quickly than you think, and they will make all the difference in your future. This is the beginning of an exciting adventure, and all of us at YCCS are proud to be part of it with you. Please join in me in recognizing officially the graduating class of 2020. And now I'd like to introduce the eighth grade speakers, Ikea Garcia and Jesus Hyman.
Good afternoon to everyone present at the ceremony. My name is Jesus Hyman, and I'm glad to be able to speak at tonight's 8th grade graduation. These 3 middle school years have been quite a challenge for all of us, but it is only to prepare us for the next big step in moving on to high school. It's felt like a big roller coaster ride, because there's been days in which it seemed too difficult to proceed, but with the help of family, friends, teachers, and staff, we have been able to continue to work extra hard on schoolwork because they motivate us and help us and always help us when we need the support. On behalf of the 8th grade class, I would like to appreciate all the help given to us to bring us where we are right now. We are just another graduating class that I can see with a bright future. Congratulations to all of us for the achievements we have accomplished. Thank you all for us attending this special event.
Sometimes you may argue, but that's only a process of becoming closer to one another. Every day, they tend to make me laugh, and I'm so grateful for that. School wouldn't be the same without them. I'm proud to say that I love my friends, and I hope we will always be this close. Even though my friends are a big part of my life, I owe my family for being supportive. My mother is the most important person in my life. I wouldn't be where I am today if she wasn't there to push me beyond my boundaries and to make me become a greater person. I can say that I love her a trillion times, but that will never be enough to cover all the love that I have for her. So I thank you, my mother, for helping me become the person that I am. I know are times we're tough, but as long as we have each other, that's all that matters. That being said, I would like to also to thank my Mima, my grandma, my godparents, Sonia and Miguel, along with my aunt, Nikki and Enrique, and my grandfather, and many others for supporting me as a little kid in Sinaloa. I love them so much, and I'm grateful to be a part of their family and lives. I couldn't have made it without them. My siblings, Isaiah and Angelina Garcia, have helped me by letting me know that they love me. Even though that we fight, it matters. It always makes me feel better when I know that they love me because I love them too. Although I may not be going to this school next year, I will still remember the times I had here. The memories of YCCS will never die, but instead live on in us. They will never be forgotten, just as the school never will be.
It's become a tradition that Duke City Charter School that we have dignitaries speak at our graduations, inspirational speakers. This year we are honored to have a special dignitary as our keynote speaker. She has the distinction of being the president of the Yuba City Unified School Board. She is known to be a strong advocate for education and a supporter of Yuba City Charter School. She's one of the most honorable and fair-minded people I know. She's my friend. Please welcome Lynette Rowe.
Good afternoon. I want to thank all of you for allowing me to be part of this special event. I've spent the last 46 years training police officers how to behave correctly in society and how to be all that they can be. And it's not easy. But I want this graduating class to understand that they can go as far as their dreams take them. Who would have thought a former member of the Black Panther Party, which I am, would go on to be a school board president, would go on to be honored by Congress as Woman of the Year for the first congressional district of the United States. I'm not saying that to brag, but I want these young people to understand that you can go as far as your dreams will carry you. I remember once when I was marching across the Verrazano Bridge with Dr. Martin Luther King, and he had marched in front of us, and we were all following him. And he said, you know what? He said, you're going to have to get yourselves back across the bridge. He said, because leaders only lead so far. And then if followers have learned, they will become leaders in and of themselves. We're honored today because these young people have shown us that they can complete 8 years of rigorous high school. Why did they choose YCCS? Well, they chose it, I believe, because they wanted a village that says one size doesn't fit all, that it's okay to be special, it's okay that to accept the smallness of the environment and still succeed. Many of you can remember when these same young people cried to get everything they wanted. They cried when they wanted to be held. They cried when they wanted to be fed. They cried when they wanted to show you that they were wet. They cried when they discovered there was more room out than in and you were left to figure out how to clean that up. These young people have learned a lot in 8 years, but they haven't done it without you. So when we look at the things that they will be challenged with in life, we at YCCS and you as parents and friends have helped them develop the skills that will take them much further than their dreams could have imagined. They can remember how difficult it was to leave home that first day of kindergarten, when you left them in a building full of strangers who didn't know their names. And they wondered, how can mommy leave me here with all these people I don't know? But what they learned in a very short amount of time was how to accept the challenge of just going to a school and being new, of just learning their numbers. And you, of course, thought they were absolute geniuses because they knew their colors and they could count to 10. They learned that there would always be one special teacher that would make them feel special. At YCCS, they learned that there was office staff that understood when they had to call home, that Mr. Cooley only had good intentions when he continued to remind him to turn in your homework on time. It's important to get to school on time, young people. And Mr. Farr's words of wisdom. You know, your superintendent was an English major, so sometimes his words of wisdom can be very, very long, right, student? So when we talk about young people and the things that they are challenged with, some of the things that they learned is you can make friends and keep them all year long. That you would learn how to share not only your ideas, but your abilities. After kindergarten, the years probably seem to fly by for them, but you still have many of the same friends, and you learn even different things. Addition and subtraction, you learn about the missions of California, you learn that boys weren't yucky and girls really could be okay. You learn who were the most important people in your life, and you learn the importance of doing homework and turning it in on time. Graduates, you learn that your parents really do expect you to do chores. But most importantly, you learned about you. You are beginning to learn who you are and who you wanted to be. Now it's time to continue your journey, graduates, to continue absorbing all that you can in life, to learn from everyone you meet, to make the right decisions, to ask the right questions, that it's okay if you don't know everything, that it's okay to be on the other side, but most importantly, it's always okay to be you. You will begin high school in August. You will feel like you're starting all over again, but you're not. The challenges may be different, but you're ready. Your years at YCCS have prepared you for anything and everything. I'm not telling you it's going to be easy, but let every situation be a learning opportunity. Use your voice if you want to be heard. Continue being just who you are, but be a better person the next day. A special thanks to all you parents, family members, friends, educators, and administrators. Without you, these graduates would not be experiencing today with such success. Just all remember that they will never stop needing you. That even though they're older, they still need you to tell them I love you. They still need you to kiss them goodbye in the morning. They may not act like it, but trust me, they still need your love and you still need to show it. Congratulations, 8th grade class of 2016.
Certified that the 8th grade class of 2016 has met the promotional requirements established by the Corporate Board of Youth City Charter School. It is now my honor to present the 8th grade class of 2016. At this time, I would ask Board President David Cha to come forward and accept the class.
Thank you, Superintendent. By the powers vested in me by the State of California, and a corporate board of the Yuba City Charter School, I accept the promotion class of 2016. I now order that the certificates be issued and that the class members be recognized individually.
Thank you.
Jasmine Brianna Ariano. Gregory Chance. Eliza Clara Jimenez. Fatima Corona. Ikea Solomon Garcia. Kenya Gonzalez Savala. Jesus Hyman. Tamara Rodriguez. Congratulations to the class of 2016. In a moment, we'll show a slideshow of the class of 2016. At the end of the slideshow, there will be a recessional played by our band, and the students will, in a straight line, go line up, and they will get their pictures taken individually. You can go online and get one of these certificates, and you can go online and purchase the pictures from this evening. So at this time, we have the class of 2016 slideshow. Thank you.